We're going to be doing something really cool today because we have a special Azure sponsored stream, which means we're going to build a virtual experience, a virtual aquarium using Microsoft's Computer Vision, AI, which recognizes all these different objects and everything in an image. And then we're going to hook it up to the Pexels API, where you can get all the different open images. We're going to make that into an overlay. So to get started with Computer Vision, we're going to create a repository. Vision show. Bam. And we're going to make this a node project. And we're going to add an MIT license. Got that. Bam. Like that. And then do the create repository. What I want to do is I want to build it as an overlay, because then we can actually put it on screen. Like anyone could use it as long as they have just an Azure key, an Azure subscription key or something to make this work. So I'm going to open this in Atom. I need a command prompt window, an editor window, and a web browser. npm init. Enter again. Okay, package name. Yes, Vision Show. Version 1.0. Description. This is the fashion show for fish using Microsoft Azure Computer Vision. Kabam! Ah! Index.js, yes, that's good. And git repository and the keywords. Sweet. Instafluff, Microsoft, Azure, Fish, Aquarium, Virtual, and Computer Vision. Show. Overlay. Browser. Source. Yeah. On. And then MIT license. And there we go. Fashion. Aha! This is the module that we're gonna need. We need npm install web web web. We do const web equals web 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 web. We're gonna run this on what's today's date? 28/2/1. We'll name it index.js because that's what we called it in package.json. And now with that, we'll just do nodemon. And anytime we edit the files, now it's gonna automatically detect. So we'll create a web page from scratch today. I'm gonna do our HTML. We need open the head tag, and then we're gonna create a title, and this will be Welcome to the Vision Show. That's what we'll call it. Welcome to the Vision Show. Close this title, close the head, and then create a body, and close the body, and then we need the script. And we save this as index.html. If we put in Vision Show h1 like that, then it should be working. That means we do localhost and then 20821 Vision Show. So what we need is we need the quick starts, and then we want the REST API for this. It should be pretty easy to do. We utilize a remote image. Yes. Using JavaScript. Aha! So we need the endpoint URL and the subscription key, and then we can analyze it. After we get this set up, then we're gonna hook it up to the Pexels API. So then we'll be able to get Pexels images based on keywords and search them. And then we'll be able to get a bunch of different images and random images. That'll be really neat. So these are the features that we would want, like description and tags, and then you have the subscription key. Let's just log in. And then we need Computer Vision. There we go. Discoverability, pay as you go. This is great. Instafluff. West US, if I can. And this will be Vision Show is gonna be the name. And we're gonna do F0, that should be fine. Let's create. Initializing, go to resource. And so I can just copy like this. Wha-bam! Copy to clipboard! But this is how it works. So you just go to the portal and then you can find whatever service you need and then you just create it. And just like that. So, let's see, I have the key. This is the subscription key. Equals. But we need a better way to just be able to put subscription keys or something into a page without worrying about, I know what I can do. Script source ploofword.js. This is the password. This is wait. The password is gonna be poof the PASUF word. And so we need to create a PASUF word, the JS, and so into window that PASUF key is going to be equal to command, like this. We need to create it into a web folder. It's web, PASUF word.js. Do web slash, and then in the PASUF word, I gotta make sure if window.PASUF key does not equal this, then console log, yes, we has key. And with that, let's try this. This should say, yes, we has key. It worked. Next, we got the quick start, and all we have to do is call with the endpoint URL. Where's the endpoint URL? Endpoint URL is this. Hi-ya. We got let, wait, I guess we can do const. Endpoint equals this. And then when we call an API, we can do fetch. And we give it the endpoint. And then we have to call it with vision analyze, like this. And so we do vision analyze slash subscription key. Subscription key equals, visualize, ta-da! And then we do subscription key equals, and then window PASUF key. Yeah, and we do that, we call it, we need some headers in here. Headers, and this is the header that we need to set the key to. So we're gonna put the PASUF key in here. Waba! And then tags. Kabam! So method will be post. It's set the body. JSON.stringify. Kabam! URL equals, and then we'll test out one of these URLs, like this one. We'll say copy image address, and we'll put that in here. We'll do then rr.json because it returns a JSON object. And I'm going to put all of these inside an async block like this so that we don't have to worry. Like now we basically have a top level async await, right? So then that means I can do await fetch. Wah! Async await, folks. And so now we get the result and we need to print out the result. So we do console.log result and wha-bam. Oh, whoops. Oh, no, it needs to be stringified because we're turning a JSON object into a string. Wah! It worked. So the thing that we need is the objects. Okay, so this is what we need to use. We need to use the detect endpoint, not the analyze. Maybe we can get the description because that could be neat. We're going to try it with the object detection and we're going to see if this works. Check this out. Check it out. It detected the object. It said object dolphin. It doesn't show anything here yet, but it will. So let's create this into an async function. I'm going to call it detect object detect detect object. And then we're going to have a URL in here. We'll get the results like this from here. Yes, we can print it out anyway. Return result.object 0.object. But this is only if there is a result.object. So result.object.length is greater than 0. Then we return this. Otherwise, we return empty string. And so there we go. We got detect object, and then we need to use this URL. So, put the URL in there, and then image source equals, and then this will be a nothing image. I'll make this an ID. This will be the image, img. Document.get element by ID, image set attribute. Source equal to, wait, URL equals this. We set this to the URL, and then we do detect object on the URL. Nope. And then we get detected. Hiya. Equals, yeah, ID equals obj. Image and obj. And so now document.getElementById obj dot inner text will equal detected, and whoa, bah! Now we got a dolphin, and it's like dolphin. We're gonna be using the Pexels API. This is going to be, yeah. If window of the Pexels spoof equals that, then console.log. Yes, we has Pexels key. Hiya. This should work. And so, there we go. Okay, are you ready? We got Pexels moving in. And then with this, the next thing we need is to know how to call the API. Async function. Get vision show images. So we're gonna do images equals await the fetch, and then we're gonna have this is the endpoint pixels, and then we're gonna do a query. We're gonna do fish. I think this will work. And then rr.json, just like this. Windows pixels pursuit. And this is going to be authorization. Wait, like this. Console log. Images. So we don't need this yet. Hiya. Let images equal. Wait, this. Headers. Whoops! Ah! 1,320? So we can do 80. We can do per page 80. Underwater fish. It's gonna be the entire window. Let's see, we got this, right? And so can we do like width equals 100%? We need to return images.photos. We'll pick a random one. So we'll just do a first one for now. We'll set this as the attribute. We'll say let URL equal images dot source original, and then this should theoretically work, because now so thumbnail equals images 0.source.large. We need to select a random image. We should get random int, and then we'll have a number, and then we'll return math.floor of number, number times math.random, and that'll give us a good index. Index equals get random int between the images.length, and then we take the index and index, and then we do this whole part. Do this whole thing. And so I'm gonna put this into a function. We'll do update image inside here. Oh. Next fission queue. And then as soon as we load this, we'll do a style here and slash style. And we'll say HTML body padding equals 0. I think this is right. I have an idea. Let objects equal this, but we are going to objects or an empty, and then objects equals objects that filter. Next, that object is not equal person. I guess we just return this. Wah-bah! Next, 0. I need to get rid of the margin as well. Padding and margin equals 0. I equals 100%. And then we do this. This is the background. This will work. Full image, and we're gonna do width equals 1vh, and wait, equals 1vh and 1vw. I think this makes more sense so that there's no scrolling. Cropped image, center crop. So if we do that, we'll do an image and ID is going to be fish and show. And older full page. Yeah, this is fine. Hi-ya. We don't need to get the context. We set the source to the image, to the URL, but then we're going to offset the position. What did I break here? So I set the URL and then I detect the object and then I do this other thing and that's fine. Okay, this is what we do. Ooh. Okay, URL equals image is the image big. Okay, and then we do URL and then we do this. And then can I just do body? Can I do element body like that? And just be like body. This will be the fish and show. Sure. And so now we don't need this thingy anymore. And never be afraid to delete code, I guess. I say I guess because sometimes I'm very afraid of deleting code. But today, no fear. And then we don't care about all this other stuff. But yeah, I'm gonna comment this out for now. Background size cover and we'll repeat. Huh. Worth a try. Wow! I think we might have done it. Do we need attachment fixed? I'm gonna put that in there too, just in case. I think we do need it. There we go. Oh, wait, I have a different plan. We can use the analysis API. So we just need this stuff. And then analyze. This is perfect. I'm gonna get the result and wow. Wait, not the dolphin. This needs a URL. Lookup info on the image. Whatever image we're looking at. And so we need to do a lookup info on the same image that we pass into the other thing. Description is going to be a weight of the thumbnail. We take the result, take the description, and then if and result.description.captions that length is greater than 0, then we're gonna return result.description.captions 0.text. We're gonna just return nothing. Async function speak text. We're gonna do text. And we'll have sample code. Ah! This language is probably loaded. Wait for it. Kabam! Wow! Alright, we don't need the synth thing. Just gonna load it again. There we go. Wah! And then we do this text-to-speech thing, but we don't need this stuff here. So we take whatever's inside text-to-speech on here, and then we put that in here, and we're like, and then other hello world. Hello world is going to be the text, and so we just replace this. And we don't need that anymore either. All right, we're gonna test the speech, the speak text. Testing this speech.
Testing this speech.
We have to set it to a timer so that every so often it updates. So we're gonna set this to an interval. Wow. And we're gonna do this every, let's say, 10 seconds. Oops, 10 seconds, because I can't count. And then we'll have a next fish. What if we do this? Plus random 0.5 to 1.5. That's probably good. All right, so now we have it on a timer. Every 10 seconds, it's gonna read out from here. I forgot. It needs to run it the first time.
It looks like clownfish.
A fish swimming underwater.
Fish swimming underwater! It looks like clownfish. Holy smokes! I can't believe it! We did it! Look at that!